rescue me. Sing it out, Jesus is alive. The empty cross, the empty grave. Life eternal, you have won the day. Shout it out, Jesus is alive.
Good morning, church. My name's Matt Cockrell. I'm a trustee here at Heritage Church, and I'd like to thank you for joining us in this little brisk morning. I want to welcome our regular attenders. We've got a lot in store for you today, but I also want to welcome the new guests. We're always thankful for visitors, whether they're coming to see the OCU choir or just coming to check out our new hospitality center back there in the back. So if you'd like to text the word welcome to the number behind you. That'd be a way that we can keep in contact with you and send you a couple text messages to let you know what's going on here at Heritage Church. So now that you know me, why don't you guys go ahead and greet each other, one another. Reach out to somebody you've never seen before. Tell them you're welcome to see them here today. And then we'll go right into the service.
Happy Palm Sunday. Amen. Jerusalem says hi. Remain standing for prayer, if you would, please. We have a special worship team with us this morning, and they are going to take care of worship, and they're for all the way from, I mean, they drove a long way, Circleville, Ohio, to be here, but you're going to enjoy their music, and they're going to lead us in some great worship. But before we do that, I'm going to have Pastor John come. He's going to lead us in prayer, if you would, please.
Please join me in prayer. God, we are so truly thankful this morning for the life that we have in your Son, Jesus Christ. And we long, God, to communicate that in every way possible. We want others to know of the freedom that comes in knowing you. And we trust this morning that as we've had a chance to find ourselves in a Sunday school room or had a chance to reacquaint ourselves with a friend that we've met up with in the hallway, God, we ask that your anointing would be upon our service this morning, and that as we hear your word sung in song this morning through our testimony, we will also hear our pastor communicate. God, our ears and our eyes, our lives, our hearts are open to you this morning. And we ask specifically that you would work in us. We freely say, Lord Jesus, speak to us. Add to our life, remove things from our life, accomplish something divine in our midst this morning. We love you, and we pray these things in your amazing name. Amen.
Amen. You may be seated. If our ushers would come this morning and prepare us for the receiving of tithes and offerings. Just want to remind you that our Wednesday night electives are starting this Wednesday. There are three classes that are available this Wednesday. Effective parenting. Y'all ready? Okay. Effective parenting in a defective world, five levels of leadership, and spiritual disciplines. Those are the three classes. I know you come and enjoy those. Especially remember to invite a friend next week. We are trying to reach 1,500 this coming Sunday. How many believe we can do that? Amen. Good. Every hand that was raised, that you're counting yourself as inviting somebody. So bring somebody along. Bring some kids. Bring some neighbor kids. It's going to be a great ministry. I believe that as God sees us reach out to our lost community, He's going to bless us. I know He is for sure. And don't forget about next weekend. There's no evening service. Spend that time with your family. Love Jesus with them, okay? We're all about family, guys. Don't forget that, okay? So, Father, thank you so much. Thank you so much for this time that we have, for what we're about ready to give to you out of cheerful hearts. God, would you please use it to touch that 22,000 and make a difference in our community. In Christ's name, amen. thank you so much for giving. I appreciate it. I know the Lord's going to bless us as we give from cheerful hearts. Guys, this is Ohio Christian University who's with us today. And I requested these guys. And so I want you to know that they've come with open hearts and they have big hearts. First of all, can I just say this? Anytime I see somebody young loving Jesus, it does something for me. Does it do something for you? Amen. So would you please worship with them as you always worship with us? Stand to your feet, honor your hands to the Lord, give glory to God, follow them in leadership, make them welcome. Sounds of Hope.
Hosanna, Hosanna, time. Great are you, Lord. Great are you, Lord.
How many of y'all believe that the Lord loves you this morning? Amen. This next song we're going to sing is called How He Loves. I wish you'd just worship with us this morning. Eclipsed by glory, and I realize just how beautiful you are and how great your affections are for me. He is jealous for me. He loves like a hurricane, and I am a tree bending.
He loves us. worshiping with us this morning. You may be seated.
Good morning. Good morning. Just checking. Thank you for worshiping with us this morning. Thank you for having us. My name is Tricia Lucas. I'm the Associate Director of Enrollment at Ohio Christian University, and we are so, so grateful to be with you this morning. Pastor Bruce got a hold of me and said, we want Sounds of Hope, and I said, okay, let's do it. And so we're so grateful to be with you. The students just, as you can see, love what they do. They have hearts to do this, and I enjoy working with them so much. But I don't want to take very long because I know we want to get back to worship, but I do want to bring you greetings from the university and from our president, Dr. Mark Smith, and just give you a few updates about the university, what's going on, some very exciting things happening, and then I'll turn it back over to these guys. But God is blessing us in tremendous ways. Has anybody been to campus in the last 6 months or so by show of hands? Awesome. Several of you. Well, thank you very much for coming to visit us. I want to just share with you, if you've been to campus, you know and have seen that we have two new building projects going on, which is very, very exciting. One of those is our Business Innovation Center. And if you go by campus, you'll see the cinder block walls starting to form there. But we're very excited about that. We've worked, partnered with a lot of people to make that building happen. And it's going to hold our School of Business and Government, as well as 10 to 15 or so small business startups at any given time. So it's going to have a lot of action in there, a lot of things going on. And one of the things I'm most excited about is that our business students will be able to see those firsthand. They'll get that entrepreneurial experience. And I'm really excited about that. I think they are too. But the other building that we have going up is our Ministry and Performing Arts Center. Right now, if you have been to any of our chapels recently, last couple years, I'd say, you would notice one thing, and that is that we are bursting at the seams. So that is a good problem to have. We just can't fit in the chapel all at once with everybody there. So this new ministry center will solve that problem. We'll get to have chapel all together, all the students at once, and we're really looking forward to enjoying that. It'll also bring a lot of opportunities for the community and different events to happen. So we're excited about that. Our programs are growing all the time. You can visit us online and learn more information, and I have a table in the back with tons of info you're welcome to take home with you. But not only on our traditional campus, which we have about 1,000 students on campus at any given day between our traditional students, our College Credit Plus students, those are our high school students that are taking dual credit classes for high school, and our adult and graduate students in the evening. So our campus is very, very busy, always something going on. With our adult and graduate studies, we have about 4,000 students now between our online programs and our on-site programs all over the state of Ohio and now down into Georgia. I'm sure you maybe have heard about that campus that has started. We're very excited about that. They're getting ready to celebrate their first graduation down in Georgia here in a couple weeks, so praise God. You can complete, if you haven't completed your education and maybe you started and you have a couple more classes to finish, please get a hold of us. We would love to help you do that. We would love to help you accomplish that goal. You can take degrees as far as associates, bachelor's, and master's. We would be happy to help you finish those goals that you have. Just to kind of conclude, I want to let you know about a couple events that are going on. Last night, I think Mark and Lois Taylor are here. Are you here? Here? Yes. They hosted our annual dinner concert, gospel music and dinner concert last night. It was great success, and we thank you for doing that. We hope that if you came, you were able to enjoy that with us. Later in April, April 19th, we have our leadership forum, and I have flyers out on the table. Feel free to take that, invite your friends, invite your family. We would love to have you. You can purchase tickets online at ohiochristian.edu and learn a little bit more about the event there. There are things that go on throughout the day, and then the main event will happen at about 6 p.m. in our Maxwell Gym Auditorium there. So please come and see us for that. We would love to have you. We also have our graduation happening on Saturday, April 30th. We have, again, grown so much. We have so many new students. We have more and more students graduating, which is a great thing. But we have graduation on April 30th. We have two graduations, one in the morning and one in the afternoon, so that we can get all the graduates across the stage. So that's very exciting. But come and see us. that's kind of the culmination of our year. That's what we're working, what we are working towards. So we're excited about that. I also have brought a bunch of magazines with me, and some of you may receive this in the mail already. If you don't, I would love to give you one to take home with you. I have a bunch out there at the table. This is our newest magazine. It came out this winter, and just gives you some updates about the university, some things going on that you want to stay connected with. And if you want to receive this at home, I can get you on our mailing list. Just come and find me, and I'll get your information and we'll get you on that list. I just want to conclude by saying these students are awesome. They have hearts of gold. Yeah. They truly have hearts of gold, and I love working with them. I get to work with them on a regular basis, and we travel together quite a bit, and they're amazing. They have wonderful, wonderful hearts. They love what they do, and they work hard. We've had some ups and downs this year, and these students are just, they're resilient, and they're wonderful, and they work so hard. So I just, would you worship with us this morning? It's not about us playing music or performing. It's about sharing worship and leading to the throne of God this morning. So we're excited to be with you. Thank you so much for having us. If you have any questions, come and find us. Get to know these guys. Ask them questions. Why did they choose OCU? What are they going to do in their ministry? What's God doing in their lives? They have some really amazing stories, and actually they're going to introduce themselves right now when they get off the stage. Thank you.
Like Trisha said, we're going to introduce ourselves. We'll start with me. My name is Josh Siebold. I'm from Xenia, Ohio. I'm a transfer sophomore, and I'm studying worship leadership.
My name is Irene Stroh. I am a sophomore, and I'm studying worship leadership and missions.
My name is Nick Lyons. I am a freshman from Delaware, Ohio, and I am studying worship leadership.
Hi, everyone. My name is Terrell Samuels. I'm from the small town of Brooklyn, New York. you guys are a lot better than the first one. They didn't laugh at all. And I'm studying pre-law and business.
Let's hope my half goes just as good as First Chapel. How many of you know where Frankfort, Ohio is? Yes, when we go to churches, nobody knows where that is because it's such a small town. We don't even have a stoplight, we just have a stop sign. My name is Rebecca Oyer, and I am from Frankfort, Ohio. I am a sophomore in the music education department at OCU. This next song we're about to sing talks about the blood of Jesus. And we're going into Passion Week when we take time and remember all the things that he's done for us. You guys are awesome and so great at worshiping with us this morning, so I ask that you just continue to do that. You guys are so amazing. Thank you so much for worshiping with us this morning. You have such beautiful voices. I would love it if you would stand again and sing this song with us. Is that okay? You guys are awesome, and I love you so much.
Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Holy, holy is He. Sing a new song to Him who sits on heaven's mercy seat.
Can we sing that part again? Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Morning. Holy, holy, holy.
Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty, who was and is to come. With all creation I sing praise to the King of Kings. You are my everything.
Again, worthy is the Lamb who was slain, and just end on that this morning.
Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Holy, holy is He.
Thank you. You may be seated. So we sang a song about love earlier, and we're about to sing about the love of Jesus again. The song is called How Deep the Father's Love. And I've said this many times at the college. Jesus didn't love us so much that he bought us a box of chocolates or a Starbucks coffee or a dozen roses. He loved us so much that he gave his one and only son to come and die for us. And I don't know what all of you are going through this morning. I don't know what is happening in your life, but I'm so grateful for the opportunity to share with you today that Jesus is absolutely right for every single thing that's wrong in your life. So as we sing this next song, just invite his presence here and bask in it. Thank you. great to worship with you all this morning. This next one's gonna be the last song that we're gonna sing for you. It's called It Is Well. It's a very familiar hymn. And the man who wrote this song, his name was Horatio. There's a lot of controversy surrounding every little detail to his life. But from the best that we can tell, he had two daughters and a wife. And they lost everything that they owned in the Great Chicago Fire. And so they decided that they were going to sail overseas to the New World. And for some reason, his wife and daughters had to go before him. And as they went, the ship sank. And he lost all of them. And as he was sailing back across, as he passed the place where they thought that they had passed away, where they had died, he wrote these words: "When peace like a river attendeth my way, when sorrows like sea billows roll, whatever my lot, thou hast taught me to say, it is well with my soul." As we sing this song this morning, I ask that you would worship again with us one last time. Just think about the Lord and how good he's been to you. I don't know what you're going through, but there's always peace, and it is well.
When peace like a river attendeth my way, when sorrows like sea billows roll, whatever my lot, thou hast taught me to say, it is well with my soul, it is well with my soul,
with my soul.
And it is now.
It bodes that we ask the right question then. Is it well with your soul? You know, that song's been used as long as I've been alive for moments just like this. Because it sets it up right. And by the way, Palm Sunday is the beginning of the end. And Christ, when he went, I know this sounds kind of coy just because I got back from the Holy Land. 1 week ago today, I was standing on the Mount of Olives. Amen. And I got to walk the path that he walked. And guys, I'm just telling you something. It's your imagination has no way of grasping the enormity of that city as he looked and wept over it. And I want to ask you the question, because Jesus, he had made up his mind, obviously, came as the Son of God. But when he went into Jerusalem, he went in to die. So that you could ask the question, I could ask the question, is it well with my soul? Is it? Bow your heads just for a second. Nobody looking around. Please, just for a second. Nobody looking around. Is there anybody out there who would say, Pastor, I want to confess. I don't know if it's well with my soul. And I want to raise my hand to let you know. I want you to pray for me. Is there anybody out there who would raise your hand and say that? Amen. Amen. See ya? A lot of hands, guys. All right, put your hands down. Would you look up? Would you mind if they sang one more verse? Would that be okay? Start with the first one. Okay, go ahead and sing the first one, like you did from the very beginning. And this is an open altar. This, one last thing before we close the service off. This week is what we call our week. This is our Passion Week. But let me explain something to you. Don't run too quick to Easter. Because it was right toward the end of that week that he said, stop, drink this, eat this. Don't forget this. That's what he said. When he said, do this in remembrance of me. He wanted us to get it all. And here's what you got to hear. You want to go to heaven? You got to follow the path of Christ. Amen. Take up your cross. Deny yourself. Follow him. So as they sing, this is an open altar. You will not pray alone, I promise. If you'll step out. Those of you, of the many who just raised your hands, wouldn't it be cool on Palm Sunday to say, I'm going to nail it down. I'm going to do it. I'm going to say yes to Jesus. Okay? So how many of you would already give a round of applause to the people that will step out? Amen? All right. As they sing, come on. As they sing, you come. Come on.
If you know that it is well with your soul, would you give a loud amen?
Amen.
He is worthy. He is worthy. Come on, he's worthy. Yeah, he's worthy. Praise his name. Praise his holy name. Amen. Not at any point trying to bring a distraction, because praise God for these who've come. Amen. Praise God. Amen. Lord, the thought, it's a fearful thought to think that we could lay our heads on our pillows tonight and go to sleep not being ready. God, that's a fearful thought. And Lord, for the many hands that were raised right now, Lord, help them not to leave this place without even now where they're at, where they're standing. Because God, you didn't say it had to be at any particular place. It just had to be in a conversation with you. Save some souls, God, today. On this Palm Sunday. God, may your sacrifice be large. Much larger than ISIS and all the stuff that the world worries about. God, may your cross, your price, your love, your grace be everything. And God, may we honor you all the days until we draw our last breath or you take us back. Lord Jesus, would you come and touch these that pray? Help them, Lord, to know that heaven is listening, that Christ will always be there, and that the blood always works. And Lord, we will honor you and we will praise you and we will give you the honor and the favor you deserve. As long as we draw breath, we ask these things in Christ's name, and everybody said, amen. God bless you. Have a great day.